Then you will tell me, oh, two people will take 1 hour, right? Because I said one person will take 2 hours, so two people will take 1 hour. So even the amount of resources you have at your disposal dictates the duration of the activity. All common sense, right? All common sense. It's just because it's PMBOK, it is very elaborate in its description. We do all of this just intuitively in our everyday life. How many people do we have? How much, you know, what are the quality of those resources, right? So even all that affects, right? So for example, if you have lower skilled resources, then you'll have lesser efficiency and therefore you'll have to give more duration. But if you have awesome solid resources, you'll be giving lesser duration. And risk register. Why do you have to refer to your risk register to estimate activity durations? Can someone tell me? Why do you need...
If they don't have the crane, for example.
Exactly. That's one example. You know, you don't even have that. And also, activities that are very risky, you want to perhaps do them a little bit more, you know, with more time given to it. You don't want to rush through it. Because if something is risky, like if it is a risky thing to put a cake on a table, we don't rush through it. We are very deliberate in our attempt. But we don't have the same risk with putting chairs in the right place and we just kind of throw them there. Right? So same thing. So if the higher the risk level of an activity, the more time you'll perhaps assign it. So wow. So that was a lot of inputs into estimate activity durations. That's why if you go back to page number 195, you will see why there were so many inputs to estimate activity durations. So let's go ahead and put that on page number 42. Page number 42, that what are the inputs for estimate activity durations, and I'll do the same in my Word document. And I'll do the same in my Word document. Okay, estimate activity durations. You guys will have to help me without referring to the book to see how much you retain. Of course, my project management plan. It has my schedule management plan, right? And then activity list. Activity attributes, I'm assuming, definitely would be there. Milestone list. Really, that was an input too? Does that affect my estimating activity durations? Yeah, it was there. You're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. Yeah. And then project team assignment, as in who do you have working on your project, right? Correspondingly, RBS, as you know, RBS stands for resource breakdown structure. RBS acronym will come up one more time in risk management. There it will be called also RBS. And there RBS will be risk breakdown structure. So if somebody says, do you have an RBS? You have to ask them, do you mean resource breakdown structure or risk breakdown?